Hello friends, this is your host Rakesh Kumar, and in this video we are going to have a look at a few examples in the live market with respect to the chart pattern double top, which we have already discussed in the previous videos that it is a reversal pattern. But before we begin, let us have a look at the risk disclaimer. It states that the futures, stocks and the options trading involve substantial amount of risk. Your capital is at risk. The losses can exceed the investment. The information is provided as is, and the user of the information assumes the entire risk of any use it may make or permit to be made. So let's get started. Okay, as I have told that we will be talking about the double pattern, I'll be quickly doing a recap that for a double top we need to have initially an extended up move, and after that we need a reaction low, then we need another high of approximately same value, and then we need to break below this reaction low. Okay, now this is when the pattern gets confirmed, when we get a break and close below the reaction low, then only the pattern is confirmed. But we don't have to enter at that place. We need a rejection from the previous support, which was this one. In this case, 1.4719 zone is a previous support zone. So when we get a rejection at this place, then only we have to enter this market. Okay, now this support zone will have turned into resistance when we get a candlestick like this. Okay, when we get a red candle, when we get a bearish pin bar here, then it is a good entry level, and a small stop loss above the pin of that pin bar and target which is equal to the height of the break from the highs. Okay, this is very simple pattern to observe, but it is very difficult to identify in the real market. So that is why I have come up with the idea of giving you this video. In this video I am going to give you live market examples of what is going on in the live markets, and we'll be taking a look at how to identify the double tops in the live market. Essentially this is a real textbook example. So in real market you will not find textbook examples. The patterns are not so ideal. There are some deviations from the actual pattern. So I will start with the pound again on the daily chart. Now this was the pattern which was formed in the month of April 2018. I have come up with. So there you see there was an extended move higher, there was an extended move higher. Okay, and then we had this first high. Okay, and then we had this low here. Okay, and this was reaction low of course after meeting this high, and then again there was a high made which was approximate in the same level which was the previous high, so we can cater it as a second high, and then there was a break of this low. Now you might be thinking that we have to create a horizontal line like this to show that this is a low. You can do this, but I will say that the support for long time was this. Okay, after for a long time this line was acting like support. So you can say that the extended move we should count from here. There was an extended up move, there was high, then there was a reaction low, then there was another high, and then there was a break of this support here. Okay, so now you got it. Can you compare it with this chart? There was an extended move, then there was a high, then there was a reaction low, then there was a high too, and then there was a break. Now you did not get this entry again in this pair. You see, of course there was a small up move, but you could not get to this level. Ideally we could have a good entry if the price would have come to this level and then reverted back like this, but we did not get this level. So you can say from this example I wanted to make clear that sometimes there is no time, or I must say you don't get a chance to enter at the test of the retest of the broken line, because sometimes after break the price may never retest. Okay, this is the one example. I hope I have made myself clear. Of course, it took the target which was equal to the height of this. I will show you how it took the target. So this was the height. I will just take this from the break, and this was the only target which was very well taken by the market. Okay, you see here it was taken. So in my next example, we have USD against the Swiss franc. This is a weekly chart. I have already made that thing. It took a lot of time to happen. Actually, it took almost 1 year to be made. You see, I must tell you that these patterns, when they take more time to develop, they are stronger, or they tend to behave more like the textbook examples when they are made by months or weeks time frame. Okay, now here you see there was an extended up move here. Then here we have our first high, then there was a low, reaction low, then we had a second high of approximate same level. We had a small break, we had a break and a close below. But do you think that this was support? No. If you think this was a support, then this is considered as break. But no, I'll say you that the support was this line. Okay, here was the support. This was the support. Okay, this was the support, and it finally broke here. After a break at this candle, the pair went all the way to 1.43386, and then it came back to retest this level as the new resistance. If you would have entered at this place, then you would have made sufficient decent profits, I must say. Because the target of the pair was taken from the break, it was the height of the pattern, and if you bring it down from the break, you will know that the target equal to the height of the pattern was easily taken. The third example is the current example on the daily chart of the Swiss franc against the Japanese yen. Now you see there was an extended move here. There was an extended up move here, then we had this high one, then we had this low. You can cater this as low, or you can cater this as low. And then we had this second high of approximate same value, and we had a break, or you can say a close below that support. So if you make, I'll just remove everything. If you think that this was the support zone, okay, and this particular candle, if this particular candle is considered as the break candle, because previous candles did not close lower than this. So if you take this candle as the closing candle, then the next day it came to retest, and after that it got rejected. And if you join these two, then you will realize that this pattern is still in run and will achieve its target, and we will continue, and I will update it once it is done, because we are considering this as the break point. So the height of the pattern is this. Okay friends, we are expecting the CHF against Japanese yen to go to 109.47 zone once at least to confirm the targets of this pattern. Now the last example in this video that we are going to discuss is this one. This was an extended up move. There was an extended up move. then there was a high, then there was a rejection low, and then there was a reaction high too, but it never broke below this low. You see, it never broke below this low. On the other hand, it actually broke above the highs. So why I have included this example in this video is that you don't have to anticipate. If you remember, that from the double top lessons, we had this thing confirmed that these are the do's. You have to look for an extended up move, you have to look for a high, you have to look for a reaction low followed by a high of almost same value, you have to look for the confirmation candle to close below the reaction low from the first high. If you miss the last point, then this is what is going to happen. You need to wait for a candle to close below this line, okay? Then only the this formation will be confirmed. Otherwise, this formation is no more double bottom. So this formation is confirmed when a candle closes below this level. I hope I have made myself clear, because we had seen it in the don'ts. Don't anticipate the break of the reaction low. You don't have to guess that the candle may break. Sorry, the low may break. You have to wait for the low to break in order to enter the market, and you have not to enter the market at the break. You have to wait for a retest. If this would have happened, then this could have happened like this. There would have been a break and retest. So where is your entry? If you are telling that this is your entry, then you have guessed it right, because this will be your entry, this will be your stop loss, and where will be your take profit, my friend? Your take profit will be equal to the height of the pattern. Always keep a target a little lesser than the target that you are thinking about. Okay, why I am not able to select it. But you got it, okay? The height of the pattern is 481 points. So from here, if you count 481 points, then you go to almost 4.239. 4.239. This will be your approximate target if the pair would have broken on the lower side. So that makes a very good sense. I hope you got all this, and I hope to see you in the next video with some other pattern. This was the double top. I think the next pattern that we are going to discuss is the double bottom in the next video. I hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you very much for watching the video.